It is bright and early on a Monday morning. I am up and showered and dressed. Got my black cat ears on today. I have to go for another follow-up on my foot surgery. Ross is going to take me to do that today. And I am waiting for the vet's office to open up right now. So hopefully I can take Mama and Mojo into the vet today while I have Ross here with a car for the night still, and hopefully get a clean bill of health on both of them so they don't have to be locked up in that room anymore, because they're not really getting a lot of attention right now because Megan's back to a full schedule at school, Kevin's working, and he's doing his best to try and take care of everything upstairs since I can't really get up and down the stairs still. So I haven't been laying with them the way that I was doing every day there. And I miss that, and I'm sure they miss that. So I'm hoping they both get a clean bill of health, and then we can get them out of that room and let them start wandering the house and get used to the whole house and to the other cats in the house. And hopefully come in here and you know, cuddle on my bed, or, you know, me force them to cuddle on my bed with me until they start getting used to us. So, anyway, I will keep you updated with everything as the day goes on, and the kids are going to start doing some decorating! Woohoo! So, I will catch you all a little later! So, I feel like a real idiot. I got Ross up nice and early and made him drive me all the way to Marina Valley, which is about a 45-minute drive, for a doctor's appointment that I thought was today, which is October 6th, that isn't until November 3rd. Smart? Telling you, this new bed's messing with my brain. Messing with my brain! So, we're on our way back home. Catch y'all later.
Ow!
Oh, never mind. He's getting down.
No.
Okay, so we'll start with Faith. Good morning, freak show Faith. How are you?
I'm... I don't even know. Oh.
You can say you're freaky.
I'm freaky.
Yay! Good morning, Rabid Ryan. How are you?
Rabid.
Yay! Good morning, pantless.
No. I have pants on. I have pants on.
Okay. All right. So since you have pants on, good morning, Ghost Hunter Ross.
Good morning.
How was your trip to Marino Valley this morning?
Really, really fun. Okay. Drove there. Drove back. Really good.
Yeah. We had a good conversation.
Two, three.
Several.
Conversations.
Shower sky?
No.
Wait.
Oh, if you don't, you know, you better play along, or it's gonna be even worse.
Okay, I got boomer.
Oh my god! You are scary.
Go to the blanket. I'm freezing.
God, boomer.
Boomer's getting attacked.
Yes, he is. Oh, yesterday I found a spot where he moves his leg like a dog. It's pretty funny.
Oh yes, he's got several spots.
Oh really?
Yes.
he just sits there and takes it.
Yes, you can pretty much do anything you want to that cat.
Hi, fatty.
Man, I want my cat to be this fat.
So, Ross, or what did I call it? Josh.
Yeah, you call him
Josh. Ghost Hunter, Ross, Josh, Pantless, whatever. Hi, Freak Show Faith.
Hi.
Oh, my babies.
You want us to put them
on? Hi, Mojo. Mojo. Mojo! gonna see the doctor. Okay, so we got Mama and Mojo Kitty in the car. We are on our way to Dr. Bart's. Everybody keep their fingers crossed that they both get a clean bill of health so they can finally start roaming the house and not be locked up in one room any longer. I am so looking forward to that because I hate having them in that room. I feel like they're in jail. I don't like it. I don't like it at all. So everybody keep your fingers crossed. We'll let you know what happened.
See, I'm looking.
Mom, Kitty, and Mojo are negative.
They are free to come out of jail.
Yay! Yay, everybody. I am so, so very, very happy. Mama, Kitty, and Mojo are negative. They do not have feline AIDS or leukemia. They can come out of jail. Yay! Hey, everybody. So you all heard, I'm super, super excited. Mama and Mojo both got clean bills of health, so they are no longer going to have to stay in jail in that room every day. I hated the fact that they were locked in one room in this entire house. I couldn't stand it. They are going to stay in there a couple more days, only because we have company staying with us right now, and both Megan and I discussed it, and we think that it would probably be better if they were left in there and were able to start meandering out into the house when the house isn't so crazy with a lot of people. And it's a more calm, quiet environment. So we're probably going to leave them in there for a couple more days until our friends leave. And then we will open up and start letting them just meander out on their own, see where they go with that and how they intermingle with the other cats and with Freckles. And we're just so, so very excited that they got clean bills of health. I could not handle any bad news. I could not handle having to say, hi, honey. Kai is here. I could not handle having to tell Nikki and John any bad news if it was bad news. So I'm so very happy that it was good news. And yay, Mama and Mojo are going to be part of our family. Finally. Catch y'all later.
Me. Don't leave me.
So if we can pull this off now. All right, there is a spot right between her shoulder blades. That's where we want to get her.
Okay, if I can find her shoulder blades.
Yeah.
She doesn't pierce through my skin. All right, right there. Okay. So I push this down and then...
Uh-huh. And then just square it all into that one spot, right into that little depression. And she's done.
Oh, wow, that is easy.
Mojo should be easy.
Mojo?
Yeah, she's the gray and white, because Mojo is very friendly kitty. All right, so here you go. Pop another one. So that was pretty easy there, Mama. Yeah. Come here, Mojo.
Mojo. Mojo. Hey, Mojo. Hey, baby.
Where's your shoulder blades, kitty?
Come on, Mojo. Let's get you out here, baby.
I'm not even going to try forcing him out here. I'm just going to put
Mojo.
It in there.
Come on, Mojo.
Okay.
Come on, Mojo. Come here, Mojo. Mojo. Boy, you're strong, Mojo. Come on, Mojo.
Okay, pop that thing. Has it popped?
Yeah, it's already popped.
Okay, hello, Mojo. Mojo, Mojo. Ooh,
he does not look happy.
That's okay. I got him.
There you go, Mojo.
He hates life. Okay.
Well, I'm sure he does. he's been in this room for 3 months.
That sucks.
Yeah, so hopefully tomorrow we'll be able to let him out. Mm-hmm. And at least into the rest of the house. Well, I guess we have to keep an eye on him because of the other cats. Just so they don't fight with each other, which I think is a possibility. So, that's it.
All right. Hey, everybody! Guess what time it is? It's time for shoutouts!
I get poked enough.
You made funny noises.
By Megan. Off camera. Just stop. You want me to start poking you?
No.
Then stop poking me.
I'm allowed to poke you.
Pinope me no.
Pinope me no? Hands to yourself! Hi, everybody! First off, I want to start by saying we are at 343 views on our Halloween Horror Nights with the Neighbors. I, personally, would like to get that vlog up to 500 views.
Maybe I should watch it.
You don't count.
Oh.
500 views. Not just in support of your friendly neighbors, but in support of the zombies, the vampires, the werewolves, the clowns, the dark Christmas elves,
and aliens and
predators.
We almost forgot about those guys. Finish your shot.
So, get all your friends to go and watch that vlog and give it a thumbs up to support your friendly neighbors, of course, and Universal Halloween Horror Nights. Ryan Beckham. He really liked Kevin's back tattoo.
Of course.
And he was saying that back tattoos really hurt. I sat for 6 hours getting my back piece done. Wasn't Sarah that did it. It was before Sarah started tattooing. 6 hours. The guy doing my back piece asked me, "Did you take anything for pain? Did you have anything to drink?" "No. You haven't even flinched. Once." It's like, yeah.
I was drinking.
If he wasn't drinking, I would have been getting the tattoo.
I wasn't feeling any pain.
I didn't feel any pain either. And you know why that is? Do you want to know why that is? Why do you think that is?
Because you're crazy.
Because women, stand with me, women, on this one, can stand pain a lot better than men can. You know why? Do you know why?
No, dear.
Because we give birth. That's right. Give me thumbs up for that, women. Come on. And to Robert's reality, welcome to the neighborhood. Vincent Gutierrez wanted to know how to get added to the credit roll.
Well, I just type you in.
But I tell him who to type. So, check it out.
Maybe I'll spell it right.
And on a more somber note, I'm very sorry to say this. Pierre Herrera, sorry for your loss. Our thoughts and prayers are with you and your family at this time. Those of you who do not know Pierre, his father has passed away. And if you could all keep him in your thoughts and prayers and his family as well, that would be greatly appreciated. Thank you. So,
that leaves me. Oh, that's right. I almost forgot. Thank you so much for pointing it out to me. See this? 14 days! No injuries! That's right, that's right. And I don't have to go in for my next foot surgery till November 28th. I'm going to be able to have fun at Not Scary Farm, which, by the way, just to remind you all, we're going to be there November 16th and, sorry, October 16th.
Yeah, that's how she got to the doctor today.
I don't know why I keep mixing up October and November. Our Halloween party. I'm not going to be hobbling around. So, it's time for the neighborhood community credit roll.
Ah, you see that she wouldn't let me put something in my ears regardless. I'm going to poke you back.
No poking me.
No poking.
I can poke you all I want.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No.
Can I poke him?
No, don't ask that.
Don't poke me! Don't poke me! I'll start pinching. You are all part of our neighborhood community, each and every one of you. We love you all. We would not be here if it weren't for you guys. Now they're going to see that if there's a Newcastle holding it up.
What a surprise.
You are all part of our neighborhood community, each and every one of you. We would not be here if it weren't for you all. We love you. Thank you. Thumbs up. And we will see you all tomorrow.
Bye.
So we did a little bit of decorating. There is more in my home. All decorated inside his coffin with spiders and spider webs, and even a snake coming out of his mouth. And now, witch, in a way now, we find you can't tell because we're not going to be able And now, male skeleton. And we have our, you can't even see it, but it's 14 days. No, get your eyes. Up there with a big spider coming down the wall. And lots of little spiders all over the spider webs back there. And a big, wide up spider web. And please do not feed the zombies.